Ozymandias of Egypt, a recitation. Before I recite, let me take you to the history or the background of the poem. Composed in January 1818 by Percy Bysshe Shelley, this is one of the most famous poems of the Romantic era and one of Shelley's best known works. It was published in the weekly paper The Examiner, and later on, that is the next year 1819, it was published in his collection Rosalind and Helen. Shelley wrote this poem in competition with his friend Horace Smith on the ruins of the statue of Rameses II, popularly known as Ozymandias, which was being transported from Egypt to London in 1818. It is interesting to note that the statue that brings out the transitoriness of life and impermanency of power should be shot by the Imperial England and also Napoleon, who before England had tried to bring the statue to his own country. This is a Petrarchan sonnet. As we all know, there are two divisions of octave and sestet. Octave of 8 lines, sestet of 6 lines. This octave goes up to the line and on the pedestal, the hand that mocked them and the heart that fed. From there the sestet begins, and on the pedestal these words appear up to the last line. Okay, now let me recite the poem for you. I met a traveller from an antique land who said, two vast and trunkless legs of stone stand in the desert. Near them on the sand, half sunk, a shattered visage lies, whose frowned and wrinkled lips and sneer of cold command tell that its sculpture well those passions read, which yet survive, stamped on this lifeless thing. The hand that mocked them and the heart that fed. And on the pedestal, these words appear. My name is Ozymandias, King of King. Look on my works, ye mighty, and despair. Nothing besides remains. Round the decay of that colossal wreck, boundless and bare, the lone and level sand stretch far away. My dear students, this beautiful poem, if you notice it carefully, you will find that when you start reading from the top, there is a speed, there is a momentum in the rhythm of the poem that goes with the sentiment that is reflected in the octave of pride, of self-important, ego, energy, which carries on till the line, the hand that mocked them and the heart that fed. And from the sestet part, that is on the pedestal these words appear, we find the momentum gradually slowing down. But final break comes after the quotation. Mark the word nothing. It's like an anticlimax. The whole momentum is broken down. It becomes too sober, as if is a reflection of sadness, the transitoriness of life. My dear students, when you read the poem aloud, this break in speed or the break in the two, stanzas, octave and sestet, should be brought out very clearly.